efforts by Philippine police to prevent further violence that marred Monday's voting in some village and youth council races. A poll watchdog believes election officials failed to anticipate where most of the violence took place. Raya Kapulong has tonight's top story.
After the voting for the Barangay and Sangguniang Kabataan elections, the Philippine National Police is now zeroing in on possible post-election scenarios. Among these scenarios is possible ballot snatching and harassment.
Yung mga post scenarios na tinitingnan na, post election scenarios, ma'am, ang tinitingnan natin is mula doon sa polling precincts, dadalhin yung mga boto, yung mga canvassing paraphernalia papunta po doon sa municipal and eventually doon po sa probinsya at doon sa national COMELEC. And definitely po i-escortan pa rin po ng mga police natin dahil ayaw natin mangyari yung nagkakaroon ng ballot snatching along the way, yung mga nanakawin at iaharas. At syempre, hanggang proclamation po yan.
The PNP also reminds everyone that the gun ban will still be enforced nationwide until November 29. There is also high police presence in areas where incidents of violence have occurred. The Philippine Poll Body says it has verified at least 19 election-related deaths, with 19 injuries related to the polls.
Figures being a cause for concern for COMELEC, of course, we, as much as possible, we don't want these incidents to happen. This is still quite low and compared to 2018. Coming from the previous elections, so we have 300 plus incidents resulting into less than 100 deaths. We have to explain to the, you know, it's have to normalize elections to the people that it must not result into any form of violence. This is a village elections. People who are voting for.
The PNP recorded 35 election-related violence, including 7 shooting incidents in Barm, Region 6 and Region 10, where 6 were killed and 25 were injured. Authorities are also investigating 103 suspected poll-related incidents. Despite the recorded acts of violence, the PNP insists the recently concluded elections were generally peaceful.
If we look at the figures po, and then the overall assessment po natin, and no less than the COMELEC po ang nagsabi na generally peaceful and orderly yung naging election ngayon. Except of course dito sa mga major incidents na naitala natin sa isang rehiyon, particularly yung bar. Sa election po ay wala po tayong naitala na failure of election, bagamat may mga na-delay po.
Officials in Barm also stress that the elections in their area were successful.
Wala pa tayong reported na failure of elections. May mga violent incidents but very few compared doon sa total number ng elected polls.
A poll watchdog, however, disputes the COMELEC's assessment. The Council for Climate and Conflict Action Asia says 17 election-related deaths were recorded in the Bangsamoro region alone. The group also blames government complacency for the increase in violent incidents in the recently concluded electoral exercise, calling it the bloodiest elections in Barm history.
We are moving towards a bigger political battle, and that is the 2025 regional election. What happened yesterday is alarming. It in fact, to a certain extent, predicts the likelihood of more violence in 2025. Now, learning from the lesson yesterday, the government ought to ensure and make it clear to everyone who will be involved in the process that they will be able to provide security on that day itself. That means if the government needs to increase the deployment of troops, it has to. Secondly, it has to focus on a lot of the hotspots that have already surfaced in previous elections. They need to demonstrate that they can control the situation in those areas.
Raya Kapulong, ABS-CBN News.
Religious leaders.